Cuchara Valley. The beauty thrills us with wonder. The vastness and spirit of the secret land grants us inspiration and vision. The stillness fills us with peace. Nestled between the eastern slope of the southern Sangre de Cristo range and the looming Spanish peaks exists a legend. Cuchara Valley and the Spanish peaks were a source of wonderment for the Plains Indians. And the Santa Fe Trail, which brought settlers across the prairie in the first half of the 1800s, relied heavily on the Spanish peaks as a landmark. And now, the legend grows. Welcome to Cuchara Valley Ski Resort, where the joy and excitement of the high country experience is reserved especially for your family year-round. Since the ski area features ideally balanced slope ratings, there are trails of Colorado snow for everyone, making Cuchara Valley Ski Resort the resort for family skiing. Take in the stunning scenery while enjoying four lifts and 25 individualized runs covering 180 acres. With a top elevation of 10,810 feet, enjoy the benefit of great skiing and hospitality without the extraneous trappings of a larger, more overrun resort. Cuchara Valley Ski Resort provides a variety of terrain and snow conditions while preserving an intimate and economical appeal so rarely experienced in Colorado. The Cuchara Valley Ski Resort's family of employees include certified ski school instructors ready to patiently show a beginner how to ski with confidence or sharpen the skills of the more advanced skier. We offer group or private lessons for all ages, and instruction is always available for both downhill and cross-country skiing. Of course, downhill skiing isn't the only winter pleasure on the hill. Cuchara Valley Ski Resort specializes in offering a constant schedule of activities for all ages. Take a thrilling snowmobile tour, explore the backcountry on horseback and sleigh, or cross-country ski by the lakes through mountain trails. However you decide to spend your time, our trained and caring family of employees are standing by to provide all the attention you need to satisfy any mountain aspiration you might have. Cuchara's lodging is affordable and convenient. Accommodations are primarily condominiums and inns located on the ski mountain, ranging from intimate to resplendent. All are well furnished with kitchen and fireplaces. Most are quite close to the lifts, and Cuchara Village is just 2 miles down the road. Dining on the mountain is convenient as well. The resort offers elaborate breakfast, lunch, and dinner locations with leisurely dining in front of a Colorado-sized fireplace. Additional fast food and beverage facilities are located in the warming lodge. The ski resort offers the complete winter experience for your family. Everything you need is on the hill. Cuchara Valley Ski Resort is proud to extend its intimate appeal all year long. We offer spring, summer, and fall packages as well to share the delight and charm of the Rocky Mountain seasons. Cuchara summers start in May with wildflowers blooming on the edge of the receding snow. They end in October when the aspens turn and present a palette of color beneath cool blue skies. Your choice of activities through Colorado's seasons are as big as your imagination and beyond. Play a round of golf beneath the famous Spanish peaks at the beautiful Grandote Golf and Country Club. Try tennis or shopping in the Cuchara Village. Guided hunting and fishing expeditions are also available at various times of the year, or just relax with a good book as deer browse, birds sing, and the breeze whispers in the spruce, pine, and aspens. Horseback riding is a natural and peaceful way to experience the high country, and the Spanish peaks, Upper Cuchara Valley, and the mountains immediately to the west provide endless, relatively undisturbed hiking and backpacking possibilities. Highway 12, known as the Highway of Legends, offers a spectacular scenic drive. Enjoy green pastures with grazing longhorn cattle, aspen and evergreen forests, and far-reaching views to the Spanish Peaks and its incredible geology. Don't forget your camera now on these ventures. The views are endless, and they're naturally worth relishing. Special art festivals and celebrations are scheduled all summer long as added attractions, as well as endless activities for everyone. The same convenient and affordable accommodations are available all year, and each season has its own special charm. Located in the south-central portion of Colorado, Cuchara Valley Ski Resort is only a 2.5-hour drive from the borders of Texas, Oklahoma, or Kansas. And Cuchara Valley is even closer for Colorado Front Rangers, being just 2.5 hours from Colorado Springs. It's families from Texas, Oklahoma, Kansas, and Colorado that have given Cuchara Valley its magic and its appeal over the years. The lure and inspirational beauty of this quiet valley is open to all of God's people, yet shared by so few. Our family at Cuchara Valley would like your family to share with us the enchantment of the gateway to the Rockies, the Cuchara Valley Ski Resort.
This here is Trinidad, jumping off place for what folks now call the scenic highway of legend. It's all built up some now, what with the railroads, settlements, and them mobile homes going every which way. But the trail's well marked. Just ask around and follow the old Route 12 signs out of town for a trip back through time that you'll long remember. Now, back in my day, you'd need a guide, hunter, scout, to get you through this high country. If you're real, you'd get me, known throughout these parts as the best of them all. The name's Hawken. Ah, the stories this child could tell you. Coal mining, ranching, farming. This country's seen it all from time to time, ever changing, yet always the same. Best fishing and hunting country in the whole of Colorado Territory hereabouts, with bear, elk, deer, beavers, turkey, and all sorts of other critters around. With the Purgatory and Cucharas rivers running chuck full of the tastiest trout this side of the Apishapa. Wagonfuls of settlers used to circle up right out here and rest a spell. And I'd help them lay of the land, guide them through the beyond in season, and spin a yarn or two around the campfire at night, when spirits, legends of the path would come alive, whisper through these selfsome pine and aspen-covered ridges. Times past, us mountain men would rendezvous back in here by the shin waters of this selfsame lake, where the high priest medicine man of a long-forgotten tribe, in a fit of jealousy, once turned the love of his life to stone. She wouldn't marry him, so she would never marry. His tears of regret later filled this valley, and she's still here, a spirit in stone, in a place called Monument Lake. A tidy to keep her dry, moving through these parts, Comanches, Apaches, and Utes lived here, to the home of the rain god, the Wahalias, the Spanish Peaks, 12,000 and more, place of worship and of mystery, even now. You can hear them for you. The Spanish Peaks, they whisper along the shorelines of these remote lakes, or reach in and stir your soul, and then move on, as you sit by the embers of your campfire in the late evening, And as you push on into the very high beyond, legends speak of lost souls, of lost treasures in Spanish gold, riches to stagger the imagination. Still up here, somewhere, ancient Aztec mines, the expeditions of Juan de la Cruz, Coronado, the search of centuries for the gold province of Dorado, centered very near here, with others trying to find the fabled Arapaho princess trait, well beyond belief, lost these mountains. Well, folks always lose something in these passes. I even lost Gretchen up here, back in the snows of 67. Well, that bro and I got some separated in that blizzard, with snow drifting up 60 feet deep in places. Well, I shouted and stomped around here several days trying to find her. You see, we were about as friends as mountain man and his burrow could ever be. Nearly froze to going under, did I, and no sign of her at all. Not till next spring did I finally locate her. Well, she had managed to survive by hunkering down next to a giant grizzly, right there in his cave, all peaceable and hibernating he was. Well, we thanked that old grizz for the wintering and decided right then to forever call this place Bear Lake in honoring of old Ephraim. Well, Gretchen was right pleased to be with me once again. Even thought I smelled good after that old bear she did. And we head on down the valley, what I always thought was shaped just like a spoon, where I built me a mountain cabin, what's still standing. The Cuchara, they calls it today. Maybe in remembrance of both me and my Gretchen. Cuchara, on the crest of the frontier. A place to get your possibles together and brace up for high adventuring. And lately a place that's taken to the raising of purebred cattle and fine horses. Up where the air is so clean, you don't hardly have to take a bath more than once a year or so. Ah, many's the night when we just sit here and watch the mountain while sharing the long pipe and be listening to the night sounds, thinking of nothing in particular, and wondering about this country we'd opened up. What would become of her down the river in a few generations or so? We'd also talk of the old ones and of their rain god. A rain god, they say, who built these walls for privacy, or to help tether the clouds close in, the better to whip up the weather and speak with their sudden storms and breath of fire, or to serve as stair steps up the sides of the Wahatoya, near to 400 of them, like spokes in a giant wheel, to better find the way to home at the top, with little bridges here and there for better footing along the way, or as stone pathways between the rivers of fire that they say once poured down from these heights, boiling up steam and vapors to hold the clouds yet closer. Vapors, they say, that mark the very spot where the mountain swallowed up the evil priest of lost loves. It was in the summer of 1862 that we all pitched in and built what we call Fort Francisco, to protect ourselves from the hostiles and as a place to gather and perambulate around. Well, sometimes we'd have ourselves a rip-rousing blowout and break harness to see the elephant, a place later called Spanish Peaks, now known as La Vita, the vein. Now there's a state park down valley. They call it Lathrop, with some mighty choice campsites ready for the picking. And even yet, the spirits come sweeping through from time to time, whipping up the waves, asking to be remembered for what they helped to build. Over 10,000 years of Southern Colorado history. Thank you. I'd pick up the settlers around here who wanted to have me help them find their way across the high beyond. They'd be camped along the Cocharis River, where Walsenburg is now situated, a crossroads place for outfitting, the northern starting place for your trip across the scenic highway of legends, where you can come face to face with the birth of a continent. And pay your respects to the little orphan, the Huerfano Butte, that rises up out of the prairie and points your way into the Wahatoyas, to its legends and to the voices of its lingering spirits.